Murphy, your instructor here at Weber State University, and today we're going to teach you a little bit of HTML. HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language. It's the language that you use to create web pages.
You'll need a browser, any browser will do. You'll also need a plain text editor. That means nothing like a word processing software like WordPad or Microsoft Word, any of those things where you can format text. We don't want that. We just want plain text. If you're using a PC, a PC has Notepad installed right on it. My favorite is Notepad++. I'm going to be using brackets in this class because it's available both for PC and for a Mac. And Mac users also have one called Text Wrangle available. All of those are free downloads and they're available in Canvas. The links are available in Canvas on a file called Intro to HTML. Now, once you install your text editor, you'll want to type in or create a new file and type in the HTML core tags. These are them right here. They're also available in Canvas. I'm going to go through what these are, so as you're typing them in, you can remember, oh yeah, this is what she said. All right, so you'll want to type in your Doctype tag. This just specifies that the language is HTML, specifically HTML5. This is an opening HTML tag, and down below we have a closing HTML tag. And a tag is anything within these brackets, and a closing tag looks exactly like the opening tag, only it has a forward slash. Some tags have closing tags and some do not. If you'll notice, the Doctype tag doesn't have a closing tag. The HTML tag just opens and closes your document. Now there's two parts of your HTML document, the head and the body. The head is everything you don't see on the web page, and the body is everything you do see on the web page. So in the head, we'll have things like JavaScripts and commands and styles and stuff that you don't really see. It's not really part of the content of the web page, but still very important. The title is in the head, and the title will appear in the title bar at the in the top tab of the page. Then you have something to specify the encoding of the web page. In this case, we want UTF-8. Then we'll talk a little bit about the body in the next tutorial. So go ahead and get that installed and get this typed in, and I will meet you in the next video. Okay, so now I have brackets installed and open. I'm going to do File New to create a new document. And then I'm going to type in all of those core element tags that we were talking about in the last video. And then you'll want to save your document. When you save, you want to make sure, number one, you remember where you save it, but also there's no spaces or punctuation in the file name. You can use underscores if you want, but I'm lazy, efficient, excuse me. So here I'm going to say my first web page, and I don't have any spaces in there. And then you'll put .html, has to have the HTML file extension, so that way the computer knows that it's a web page. Then it will color code my tags once it's been saved. Okay, so here's all my tags. I'm going to put a title in the title tag, so I'll say my first, I didn't write it right. And then I'm going to show you your first HTML tag that goes in the body. And that is an H1 tag. An H1 is a header tag sized 1. You can have as many H1 tags on your page as you want. It's just tells you what size, just like the headers in Microsoft Word. Then I'm going to put on a paragraph. And a paragraph is just plain text. It's not been formatted at all. And then we'll save this document. The paragraph is a P tag, by the way. And make sure you save the document with either a Control S or going File Save. And then when you're ready to view the document, you can browse to where it's located. And if you just double click on it, it will open in whatever your default browser is. And here I have, there's my first web page, has my H1 tag here and my title that's up here. Then it has my paragraph. You can have as many H1 tags. So let's do now another size tag. I'm going to do an H2 tag. And my H2 tag, maybe I'll put a little paragraph after that. So I can have a H2 tag for a reason. And Control S once again to save this. Now, if you come over here, you're going to view the changes immediately. It's not till you hit F5 or refresh until you actually view them. So you can see that an H2 tag is a little smaller than an H1 tag. Here, I'm going to show you how to add a little bit of color to your web page. And I've got my first web page that we started last time going. In the body tag, I'm going to say style equals, and style just lets you style the web page. Then to add the color, you do a color colon, and I have the color scheme generator over here, or you could just put standard colors. So you can type in purple and it would actually work. So here I've chosen purple for Weber State, and I'm going to hover over this. I'll do a dark color for the text, and I'm going to just type in that color code that it says. Now, as you type it in, you need to make sure you put this hashtag there, otherwise it doesn't work. Okay, so that's the color of the text. The background color is background dash or minus, whatever you want to call it, color, and then you pick whatever color you want. I'm going to do this 66004. I'm not sure what I typed in, but I copied and pasted over here to be fast. Don't forget the hashtag, otherwise it doesn't work. Now, as I save and refresh this page, now I have a background color and a text color. Depending on where you put this in your code is what it will style. For example, we put it in the body tag, so it styles the entire page. I could easily put that into my H2 tag or H1 tag, if I could spell style and talk at the same time. Style equals, I'm going to say background dash color white, and another new one, you can do text dash align center, and that will center the text. So now just that one tag is going to be stylized. Well, good luck with adding color to your web page. And I'm going to show you how to add a list to your web page. Now, lists are nice. They can be either numbered or bulleted. I'm going to start off with a bulleted list. Here I'm going to list my favorite foods. Now, this is just a header, obviously. We've done headers before. Now, the list for a bulleted list is UL. It stands for unordered list. Each of the list items within there are LI tags, so LI list item. And then within there, you can put several list items until you have whatever type of list you want. I'm going to put at least three because, you know, what else is there? Pizza, sushi, tacos. Got to have tacos every day, yeah, I'd say. Anyway, so that is how you create an unordered list. And if I save this, I can refresh the page. I can see that I have bullets. The only difference between an unordered list and an ordered list is this opening and closing tag. If I change this to an OL tag, then I now have numbers. All right, good luck adding lists to your web pages.